Hey guys, Sergio here. I'm gonna do a movie review on a movie that I just got today. I bought this on eBay, and it came in the mail today, and I just watched it. The movie is called Night Skies. Right there. I've never heard of this movie. This is supposed to be based on true events. This is something that happened on March 13, 1997. There was a famous incident where there were some lights in Phoenix. They have never been explained. You can still watch the video on YouTube. Just put Phoenix lights and you can see home videos of stuff that people videotaped that night. These lights that just appeared out of the sky. And nobody's ever been able to explain what those lights were. But this is supposed to be something that happened that night when those lights appear to happen to a group of people that were they were actually driving to Vegas when the lights appeared over Phoenix. They were going through Phoenix when the lights showed up in the sky and something happened to them. It's about five kids, probably in their early 20s, and they have a motorhome and they're all driving to Vegas, and they happen to be driving through the desert when one of the girls noticed these lights in the skies. And they're distracted by these lights, so they're looking at them. And when the guy's driving, he's not paying attention to the road. And there's actually a truck that broke down in the road. And when he turns around, he has to swerve out of the way, and he ends up getting into an accident. They end up getting stranded in the desert. When they crash, one of the guys accidentally gets stabbed. The guy that was in the truck broken down, he happens to be an EMT. So he tries to help these kids because their one guy's injured. After not being able to fix the guy's truck, not being able to fix the motorhome, two of the guys decide that they're going to go hiking for help, and that's when the strange things begin to happen. They realize that they're not alone in the desert. They don't know what exactly it is, but there's something else out there. They realize soon that there's actually aliens, the lights that were over Phoenix, and they happen to be out in the desert, so that the aliens are actually surrounding them and trying to abduct them pretty much. Like I said, this is supposed to be a true story of what happened that night. I've never heard of this story up until this movie, but it was a pretty interesting story. Eventually the aliens start surrounding they end up abducting them one by one. And the next day, there's this ranger. He happens to find the guy that was in the truck. And he actually remained in a comatose state after they found him the next day after the Phoenix lights. They found the guy in the desert, and he remained in a comatose state for a year. After he woke up after a year, he went through some hypnotic therapy. And that's when he started remembering these events and what exactly happened that night. They did an investigation. Those five kids that were in the RV, they never found them. An RV was never found. No missing report was ever filed. But this guy insists that this is what really happened. And he's taken lie detector tests and he's passed them. So it's a pretty interesting story. The movie was pretty good, the story was pretty good, but I think that at the same time, the movie lacked originality. The noise that the aliens made, it kind of reminded me of the movie Signs. In the movie Signs, there's a part where the little kid, he raises a baby monitor into the sky, and you can hear the aliens. It kind of has like a kind of like that type of noise, and those are the aliens talking. When the aliens are nearby in the movie, you kind of hear that noise. When the aliens are in the shadows, they kind of look like the aliens in the M. Night Shyamalan movie. Once you can see their faces, they don't look like that alien, but when they're in the shadows, they have that similar figure that they did in the Signs movie. Also, the aliens, at some times, they actually sound like a predator. That noise that the predators made, you kind of hear that a couple of times. So, and there's also a scene where one of the guys and one of the girls, they wake up on the spaceship, and they're being examined by the aliens. It kind of reminded me of Fire in the Sky when they wake up, when the guy wakes up on the spaceship and there's all these weird, like, it kind of looks like the walls are made of flesh, kind of in all this slime. That's what it was similar to this. It kind of reminded me, that part reminded me of Fire in the Sky. So it was an interesting movie. I enjoyed it. It reminded me of other movies when I was watching it. It's not a low budget movie. It looks like they spent a nice fair amount of money to make this movie, so that made it pretty interesting itself. But it was decent. It was pretty good. I enjoyed watching it. It just, like I said, it lacked originality, but it's the fact that it was based on true events made it even more interesting. So I do recommend it. I think people would enjoy it. They did a really good job with the aliens. They look very realistic. They don't look fake. I actually think that the aliens in this movie looked a little more realistic than the aliens in Fire in the Sky. So that made it even more interesting itself. But it was a decent watch. I'd watch it again. So that's Night Skies. I do recommend it. Watch it. It was a good watch. I enjoyed it. It kind of creeped me out a couple times. I had my hair stand up. I got goosebumps a couple times. But it is late at night, and I was watching it by myself also. So that's my update for today, my movie review. Night Skies. I enjoyed it. Good movie. Never heard about it until today that I watched it. But it was well worth my time. Thanks for watching, and stay tuned for more.